Okay, now last but not least for this section, so we've gone through sensing, we've gone through how you actually use if-then conditional statements, but one of the other things that we have to go over is this block section here called operators. Now, if you click on this, basically what this means is that when you set certain situations in your Scratch program, if you want to go ahead and make your conditionals really, really specific, you can use these blocks to code for them. So let me show you what I mean. So for example, right now I've already got an if-then statement for when my main sprite, which is the soccer ball, goes to the right and when it goes to the left, based on whether I click the right arrow on my keyboard or the left arrow. So let me go ahead and show you what I mean. This is kind of similar to what we did before. When you press right, it goes to the right. When you press left, it goes to the left. Now, normally in soccer, when the ball is somewhere specific, like in a goal, you're going to hear a lot of clapping. So actually, I'm going to go ahead and show you how you can use this with the operators to make some clapping happen. Now, I've gone ahead and I've actually recorded my own sound. Let me go ahead and pull this up. I have a recording, but I'll go ahead and do it again so you can see what I did. You hit the new recording button. And when you want to go ahead and make the recording, you just go ahead and press this button right here. So let's go ahead and make it. I'm going to try and go a little bit crazy, like it's the crowd getting really excited at a game of soccer. Here we go. Woo! Yeah! Woo! Okay, perfect. Now let's go ahead and play it back and see if we like it. Woo! Yeah! Woo! Fabulous. A tad bit embarrassing, but that's okay. For the sake of this, I'll go ahead and stick with it. Now let's go back to scripts. Now, in order to use operators, you do have to again use the if and then statements. So let's go ahead and start off with when green flag clicked. And remember, when you're doing things that you want to last throughout the duration of your Scratch program, you have to have the forever block in there. So we'll go ahead and lock that in. And then I'm going to tag in my if and then statement. Now this is all ready for us to start manipulating. So to use an operator, I'm going to focus on these three here, and, or, and not. Now the first block, something and something, basically means that you can set two conditionals for the if part of your statement. So if this is happening, and this is also happening at the same time, then it'll cause the third action. So let me show you what I mean. Let's say that we want the clapping sound to happen when the soccer ball, whoops, go ahead and take that out and make sure you put that in. When the soccer ball is touching the referee, and let's also say when I have the space bar pressed. Okay, so theoretically, whatever it is that we put in here, we have to have both of those things happening in order for it to create whatever action I'm going to choose. And I'm going to go ahead and do the sound that we just did, recording one. Okay, so let's go ahead and try this and see if it works. If the ball is touching the referee and the space bar is pressed, it should play recording one for the sound. Here we go. Green flag clicked. Push my ball over. Now it's touching the referee, but nothing's happening yet. So let's go ahead and see what happens when I press the space bar down.
Woo! Yeah! Woo!
Perfect. I satisfied both the first if and the second if, and so it played the recording. Fantastic. Now we're going to go ahead and take this part out, and we're going to leave this in for now, just for reference. I'm going to cut out this block. We're going to go back to operators and do the next one, which is something or something. So let's go ahead and take this out. Now, for the sake of this, basically what this means is that instead of two actions happening at the same time in order for the then statement to take place, if one or the other happens, it'll still cause the action to happen. It doesn't have to be both, meaning that these two actions aren't independent. So let me go ahead and show you what I mean. We're going to go ahead and take this out. We're going to start fresh with a couple of new sensing blocks. Let's say that we want the ball to say a message if it's either touching the referee or touching the goal. So we'll do this. We'll put in the touching the referee again. But for this one, we'll put touching color And then we'll choose one of the colors on the goal. So if the ball touches it, that means that whatever action we've decided will go ahead and take place. So these two things don't have to happen at the same time. They can happen independently. And then let's say that for the actual look, our ball is going to go ahead and say something. So right now it's saying hello because actually the ball is technically touching the referee. Let's go ahead and move him off there for a second. And we'll stop this. Okay, so let's have him say, go team. And we'll do it for 1 second. Okay, so if the ball is touching the referee or the ball is actually touching the orange color on the goal, it should theoretically say go team. Let's give it a try. Here we go. To the left, go team. And to the right, go team. Perfect. Excellent. So even though those two actions don't happen at the same time, the soccer ball is still going to go ahead and do what we asked it to, which is say, go team. Now, last but not least, let's take these out. And this one as well. And we'll start fresh with the last operator that I will be talking about, which is not something. If you lock that in, this basically means that whatever the ball is doing, as long as it's not doing something, it's going to go ahead and do whatever action you dictate. So let's say that if it's not touching the goal, and we'll go ahead and put in that color again, then it's going to say, try to get me in. Try to get me in the goal. So we'll go back up to looks. Go ahead and say, instead of hello, let's do, and we'll click this off, try to get me in the goal. And that'll make sense because when he actually gets in the goal, he won't need to say that anymore. Okay, so here we go. We're going to go ahead and click green flag, and there you go. He's not actually in the goal yet, so he's still trying to get people to get him in the goal. No matter where we move him, he says it until, there you go. Now that he's touching that color, he's not saying try to get me in the goal anymore because technically he is in the goal. Awesome. Now the best part about this is that you can set all sorts of conditionals to essentially have sprites do what you want depending on very, very specific situations. So I encourage you, play around and try to set in different sensing blocks with the not, and, or, because there are a whole bunch of things that you can do to create really fun games for you, friends, or other people to play and enjoy.